Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. Unfortunately, Feels by Calvin Harris, the song that I was going to mention in this video, great track by the way, but unfortunately got blocked by YouTube, so I wasn't able to upload it, so I just had to trim that portion out, but everything else is fine, the other four are there, and in fact, I'm going to post that portion of the video on my Instagram at kev_music, so if you're interested, be sure to check it out. But other than that, everything else is fine. Thank you so much for stopping by, I appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.
Hey everyone, it's Kevin here. Today I'm going to be starting a new series where I talk about my top 5 favorite bass lines for each genre. This is episode 1 and it's all about pop. To me, pop bass lines kind of fall into two categories. Either it's the main focus and it really drives the beat forward, carrying the main rhythmic and harmonic structure of the track. Or it just stays in the pocket, allowing a good foundation for all the other instruments to sit on top of. Or even it could be a combination of both, where the bass line carries that nice, subtle bottom, and then out of nowhere, there's this one moment in the song where it just goes crazy. The first song on the list is Don't Start Now by Dua Lipa. Don't show up. This bassline utilizes some key elements from disco music, such as octaves and putting notes on the and of the beat by playing with the melody instead of underneath it. To me, it sounds like it's being played on a jazz bass, which gives it some nice mid-range growl. Next up on the list is S.O.S. by the Jonas Brothers. So this is where the story ends. A conversation on I am. Well, I'm done. We're texting, sorry for the miscommunication. The main riff starts out with guitar in the beginning and then slowly comes to the bass in the second verse. And when it comes in, because it's playing the exact same part, it really adds another level of depth to the riff. Similar to Don't Start Now, it uses some octave patterns. That does nothing more than get you in the groove. Played with the pick on a P bass really gives it a solid punch that sits well in the mix. Next on the list is Runaway Baby by Bruno Mars. I love you so, hey, that's what you'll say, that's what you'll say. You'll tell me, baby, baby, please don't go away, don't go away. But when I play, definitely one of the most recognizable bass lines in pop music, in my opinion. The bass kicks off the track by providing a clean, precise, and distorted tone. From the first beat, you can really feel the pulse of the song. And then later, this line carries over to the guitars and synthesizers, really just adding so much to the mix and making that riff the main part of the song. It propels the groove like no other. Next up on the list is La La Land by Demi Lovato. Now this is definitely one of those songs where it holds the groove in the beginning and then out of nowhere it just goes crazy. Hits you with this obscure pattern that you would typically see in progressive rock music. And again, with the guitars adding just another level of depth with the unusual intervals, really makes this part the highlight of the entire song. And each note really lines up with the chords and the melody, so they're working together. Almost as if there's some type of conversation going on between the instrumentalist and Demi. Alright, last but not least on the list, Feels by Calvin Harris. When I first heard this bass line, I was like, whoa. Just the raw tone caught my attention immediately. The song as a whole is just a really feel-good summer track that can be on any DJ's playlist. But in my opinion, and no biases here, the bass line really takes over the entire song. And it features great artists like Katy Perry, Pharrell, and Big Sean. But supporting those fantastic artists is a bass line that will keep you in the groove and have you humming it later, like me. It takes cues from Motown, funk, disco, with some pop flavor to it. Alright guys, those are my top favorite pop bass lines. And please let me know in the comments which is your favorite pop bass line. I plan on posting more content like this as well as my bass covers. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. It really helps the channel out. I have a bass cover coming at you on Friday. And I'll see you guys later.